Witam Was wszystkich bardzo serdecznie w kolejnym odcinku naszej serii Zagrajmy w Metal Gear Solid 2 HD. Ja jestem Sarge, no i cóż, właśnie zjeżdżamy na poziom B2, gdzie mamy spotkać się ze Snake'iem i Otaconem, którzy opiekują się teraz Emmą Emmerich, która została ostatnio dźgnięta nożem przez Vampa, więc oglądajmy.
How's Emma?
I think he got some internal organs. We can't stop the bleeding.
Hal?
I'm here.
Got the disc. Emma set everything up. Apparently, all you have to do is pop in the disc. That should insert the virus into the AI.
Is it working?
Just leave it to Emma. What the?
An antibody agent?
Damn! The connection's been cut.
Is the virus upload complete?
I don't think so. The count stopped at 90%. Otacon.
I don't think Emma's made any mistakes, but a portion of the worm cluster might have been altered after the disc left Emma's hands. By the Patriots?
Will the virus still work?
I have no idea.
Hal is... Is everything all right?
It's all right. Everything's all right.
Good. At least I won't be adding another page to our family's dark history.
Yeah, that's right.
What if the virus doesn't work?
Either destroy that thing or take out Solidus and his men.
How do we get on board?
I don't think we can. Unless somebody inside gives us a hand.
Hal. I always...
What is it?
Wanted to see you again.
You don't hate me?
Never. I never wanted to get in your way. I never wanted to hurt you. I thought that with Arsenal, if I followed in your footsteps, I could be closer. I just wanted you to look at me. Look at me as a woman.
Never do that.
Don't be so honest. It hurts.
Sorry.
Can I ask you one last favor?
Sure.
Call me Emma.
What?
Please call me Emma.
What's wrong with EE? Emma? 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 Answer me!
Thank you.
biedny Otakon musiał stracić siostrę tuż po tym, jak ją spotkał po wielu latach.
I didn't leave you because of the accident. I had a relationship with your mother. She seduced me, and it went on. My father's death was no accident. He took his own life. It was my fault, all my fault. Forgive me, Emma.
No i co, spodziewaliście się tego?
Gear is ready for launch. Evacuate the upper levels immediately.
Sounds like they're cutting this area loose. What do you mean?
It means we're gonna sink.
We have to get the hostages out. What about the Kamov repairs?
Done.
We won't be able to get everybody aboard. We'll just have to take as many as we can.
My sister won't be able to come with us.
We will be commencing the countdown shortly. Personnel in the upper levels, head for the evacuation area immediately.
I'm always the survivor. Why, Wolf?
Wspomnienie z pierwszej części.
Take care of the hostages.
What about you guys?
We got other arrangements. There's our ride out of here. Anyway, we're gonna have to sink that thing if the virus doesn't work.
I should be going with you.
You've got your job, we've got ours.
You mean I'd only get in your way?
Wrong. Only you can save those hostages. Got it?
Right. Listen, the two of you won't be able to destroy that thing. Eliminate the enemy. That's your only option.
No i niestety w takiej sytuacji musimy tutaj zostawić Emmę i dalej działać.
Try to get as many hostages out as you can. It's a short flight to the shore, so don't worry about overloading the Kamov.
Leave it to me.
it's you.
You and me, we're the same.
Strasznie smutne i przejmujące sceny, a dodatkowo jeszcze ta muzyka, to wszystko dodaje jeszcze bardziej temu wszystkiemu dramaturgii.
Both you and I, we were always alone. Always. We only wanted to be loved. We were always waiting. Waiting for somebody. Somebody who would love us, but we were wrong. You can't wait to be loved. You have to go out and find it. 4 years ago, I realized that you can't just wish for a happy family. You have to make it happen. I only wish I knew that sooner. I learned that I could love, as you probably did, Emma.
You think he's gonna be okay?
He's tougher than he looks. Consider it done.
Now, how do we open this thing?
You can come out now.
A ninja? What the...
No proszę.
Arsenal's going to take off. We still need you to take care of a few things. This time, don't fail us.
Snake, what's this all about?
Bedtime, Raiden. I wouldn't do that.
You're changing sides now?
Change sides? I don't recall saying I was on yours.
Damn it. You!
Ready for some shut-eye.
A więc ninja to Olga Gurlukowicz tym razem. No i o co chodzi Snake'owi? Oczywiście ja wam tego nie zdradzę teraz. W ten oto sposób Big Shell zatonęło. Ale co się dzieje z Raidenem? Chyba dzwoni Rose.
Jack, are you reading me? Do you want to save your mission data up to this point?
Okej. Okay. Rose nam proponuje zapis. Raiden się nie odzywa. No ale dobra, skorzystamy w takim razie z tego. Aczkolwiek niedawno właściwie zapisywaliśmy grę. No i teraz tak naprawdę jest niewiadome, co się dzieje z Raidenem i gdzie on teraz przebywa, ale za chwilę się wszystkiego dowiecie.
Your mission data has been saved.
Is he still alive?
He was when Olga brought him in. I've checked everything, including the genome data, but there's nothing on this guy. NSA, CIA, FBI. He doesn't exist in any database. He's a non-existent operative from a non-existent organization.
I suspected as much. However, I know this man.
Hmm?
Wake him up.
No i proszę, to wam coś przypomina? Niczym w pierwszej części serii.
It's been a while, hasn't it? Jack the Ripper.
You know this fellow?
You remember me, don't you? You've grown. High concentration of cerebral implants. Have they altered your memory, too?
Muszę tutaj szybko wciskać trójkąt, żeby przetrwać, niczym w pierwszej części. Mamy tortury swego rodzaju. Mamy Ocelota i Solidusa Snake'a.
This is my son. I taught him everything. Jack, I never thought I'd see you again.
You know me?
You don't remember. Your name, your skills. Everything you know, you learn from me.
Spodziewaliście się tego?
The 80s. A civil war. You were one of the best among the child soldiers that fought in that conflict. When you were barely 10 years old, you became the platoon leader of the small boy unit. At the time, your outstanding kill record earned you several nicknames, including White Devil and Jack the Ripper. Jack, I was your godfather. I named you. When the war ended, you disappeared from the relief center. I wondered what happened to you. I should have known they would recruit you.
It's an interesting coincidence.
If he's a lackey for the Patriots, I doubt he knows anything of interest.
What should we do with him?
We'll use him like you suggested.
What about Dead Cell?
Ignore them. Happening again?
Could it be that he's here too?
In another hour, we demonstrate the power of Arsenal gear.
Attack with standard weapons, of course.
Yes, proceed as planned.
At last report, all is well with GW.
How about the troops?
The men are being refitted with Arsenal gear equipment as ordered. You're the spitting image of Big Boss.
Is that so? Perhaps I should be grateful to this kid for that.
This situation, I find it very nostalgic.
Where am I?
Why, inside Arsenal gear, of course. Actually, we're also inside the memory of Shadow Moses. I'll take this back. You don't need this anymore, do you? A foul wind is blowing. We shall speak again.
Don't move. Stay as you are. We're being monitored by a camera.
What are you up to?
I'm switching over to nano-communication.
Mr. X? Ninja?
Correct. It's me.
I thought you were the leader of the Russian troops.
No, that was just a smokescreen.
A smokescreen?
I was sent to provide you support.
Support? Who sent you? The Colonel?
No, the Patriots.
What?
I deceived my troops, betrayed them.
But why?
My child is... being held hostage by the Patriots. It all started 2 years ago when I lost my father during the tanker incident. My men and I had nowhere to go, so we joined forces with an illegal Russian organization.
The Russian Mafia?
Something like that, actually. I learned much later that it was a subordinate organization of the Patriots. I was expecting at the time. When I gave birth to my child, it turned out I was in a hospital run by the Patriots. In the morning, my child was gone. My baby is being kept somewhere in this country.
Have you ever met your child?
No. Once a month, they send me a photo of my child via network. I've never even held the child in my own arms.
I see. Given your situation, nobody can blame you for what you did.
That's your opinion.
What about Snake? I thought you were enemies.
He wasn't responsible for my father's death. Actually, we owe him our lives. 2 years ago, they were responsible for getting us out of the sinking tanker alive.
So you were partners since the incident?
No, I only found out the truth shortly before this.
Huh?
When I confronted him here.
You fought with Snake? When?
Well, it was around the time you were holding hands with that girl.
Snake.
No proszę. Snake nie wszystko mówił Raidenowi.
So you joined hands with him to pay back a debt?
No, mutual gain.
Mutual gain?
My job was to assist you. If Solidus gets away with Arsenal, your mission is a failure. The Patriots would judge that as failure on my part and terminate my child. Putting it simply, my child's life depends on your success.
So you did it all for your child. But why would the Patriots want to help me? Are they hoping I'll take Solidus out?
No, you're just like me. We're just pawns.
Pawns for what purpose?
The S3 plan.
Huh?
You'll figure it out sooner or later, but I wonder if you'll handle the truth.
What do you mean?
Listen, we haven't got time for this. Solidus will commence his attack any minute. He's got to be stopped.
What about the virus?
No results so far. I think the Patriots have tampered with the program.
Will it work?
I don't know.
Get me out of this thing.
Not yet. I'll release your restraints after I leave this room.
Where's my gear?
Snake's got everything. I couldn't bring it here.
And where do I find Snake?
The passageway ahead leads to a hangar. He'll be waiting there. I gave him a card key for the hangar.
Does Snake plan to destroy Arsenal gear?
No. Even for Snake, it's impossible to completely destroy this thing. The only option is to stop Solidus and his men.
What are you going to do?
Stay concealed. That's my role. I still can't afford to be discovered.
Olga, you can't keep this up. They're bound to find you.
Listen, I'll free you in a little while. Brace yourself.
No i dobra, Olga nas opuściła, ale najwyraźniej ma nas tutaj uwolnić. Naprawdę sporo było filmików, muszę przyznać, praktycznie ponad 20 minut. No ale jednocześnie było wiele bardzo ciekawych informacji tutaj ujawnionych. No i mamy znowu kodek. Odbierzmy, to chyba znowu Rose.
Jack, are you all right?
Oh, yeah.
Jack, is it true what Solidus said?
Yes.
It's unbelievable. Drafting small children, sending them to war? It's not allowed under international conventions.
ICC rules don't mean a lot in war. Someone told me that there are over 300,000 children in combat right now. I was just one of them.
So you remember? I thought your memory had been manipulated by them.
It was. But I have nightmares every day. Pieces of the past I can't put together.
Why didn't you tell me?
You couldn't begin to understand.
You wouldn't know that until you try me.
I didn't want you to get hurt. There was never a real reason for me to fight, except that someone put a gun in my hand. And that someone was him.
It wasn't your fault.
If I survived the day's fight, I was praised, fed, and had a bed to sleep in. I think I was only 6 when I held my first AK. But I'm not even sure of that.
Jack.
I'm not like Snake. I never questioned why we fought. There was no purpose, no way out. They give you a gun, you ask how many to kill. If you didn't, you were the one they shot instead.
It's okay. No one is blaming you.
We were shown Hollywood action films every day. The kind with macho guys and big guns. They call it image training.
Ugh.
They built us from the ground up into killing machines. We were fed once a day. I can still taste the gunpowder they mixed into the food.
Gunpowder? In the food?
The gunpowder had toluene in it, giving it hallucinogenic properties. It kept us drugged, controllable.
Oh my God!
When the Civil War ended, those of us who survived were taken in by NGOs. They gave me a new life in the States. I can't complain. But nothing's changed. The only people who have no problem with my past have secrets and agendas of their own. Terrible nightmares. Every night. I can never forget.
Jack.
I'm afraid of the night. That's why I don't sleep next to you.
You should have told me.
Told you what? That I'm a killer? And always have been?
No. No.
What I hate more than anything else in the world is my own past. I didn't want you or anyone to know about it. Now I know why I was chosen for this mission. No one can take him on, take him down, except me. I've been kept alive this long for this. I knew as soon as I saw Solidus.
Jack, I love you the way you are now. You have to believe me. I didn't know anything about you, I admit that. Where you were born, how you grew up. But I know that now. And I know that what I feel for you can only get better. And I'll share in your past if that's the price.
It doesn't work that way. No one can share the burden of what I've done. It's not one of those warm and fuzzy things couples share.
I accept the good and the bad, Jack. That's what you do for someone you love.
I don't want to share my past with anyone. I just want to forget about it.
Jack, I haven't told you, you know, about what I've done.
The last 2 years with you, it's been more than I've ever hoped for.
Jack.
But I can't go any farther. I know you want to get married. But I can't. I can't risk starting a family. There's no way to erase my childhood.
It's all right, Jack. Please, don't say any more.
No i proszę, dowiedzieliśmy się nieco więcej o Jacku Raidenie. No ale Olga w końcu nas wypuściła, no i w ogóle to jest dość zabawny fragment. Fragment, którego za bardzo nie lubię, bo musimy oglądać niestety nagiego Raidena w tym momencie. On się w taki przekomiczny sposób tutaj zasłania. No ale cóż, sami widzicie jak to jest. Jego kombinezonu tutaj nigdzie nie ma w tym momencie i będziemy musieli dosłownie parę korytarzy przebyć właśnie takim nagim Raidenem. Czy tego chcemy, czy też nie? A więc tym zajmiemy się już w kolejnym odcinku. Tak, oczywiście zdaję sobie sprawę z tego, że ten odcinek był praktycznie w całości poświęcony tym filmom przerywnikowym. No ale cóż, ja was uprzedzałem na początku tej serii, że tak się może dziać i do końca tej serii jeszcze pewnie będą takie odcinki, że będą same praktycznie filmy przerywnikowe, bo im dalej, tym coraz tego jest więcej, coraz więcej się wyjaśnia. No ale mam nadzieję, że tutaj wam to nie przeszkadza, no bo tak czy siak wy i tak oglądacie tą grę na YouTubie, a więc chyba nie sprawia wam wielkiej różnicy, czy tutaj jest akurat jakaś rozgrywka sama w sobie, czy też po prostu same filmiki. Zresztą ja zawsze byłem zdania, że te filmiki są na tyle ciekawe, że absolutnie nie można się nudzić oglądając je. Tutaj w ogóle właśnie widzimy, że rzeczywiście to wszystko wygląda jak ta cela na Shadow Moses. To też zostanie zresztą wyjaśnione. Zresztą już tam Ocelot wcześniej powiedział mniej więcej, że jest to swego rodzaju symulacja tego. Wejdę tutaj, wezmę Ration. I jeszcze zajrzymy sobie do szafy. Dobra, mamy lekarstwo, na wypadek gdybyśmy się tutaj przeziębili. No i ogólnie tutaj się wychodzi na zewnątrz i będą nas czekać właśnie tutaj kolejne lokacje Arsenal Gira, gdzie będziemy musieli się skradać. Jeszcze na chwilę odbierzmy kodek od Campbella.
Raiden, do you copy? You must continue your mission.
I've lost all my gear. I need to locate Snake.
He was never factored into the simulation. Leave him out of this.
I can't do much naked, especially in this temperature.
That's true. You won't be able to attack or enter the hanging mode either.
I think Snake has my gear.
Raiden, take out Solidus and his men. You must recover Arsenal intact.
Colonel, are you under orders from the Patriots?
Your role, that is, mission, is to infiltrate the structure and disarm the terrorists.
My role? Why do you keep saying that?
Why not? This is a type of role-playing game. The point is that you play out your part, and I expect you to turn in a perfect performance.
Colonel, I just remembered something.
What?
That I've never met you in person. Not once.
Complete your mission, according to the simulation.
Colonel, who are you?
No more questions. We have Rosemary.
What do you mean by that?
Over and out.
No właśnie, chciałem, żebyście jeszcze usłyszeli sobie tą rozmowę, dlatego że jest ona dość ciekawa i intrygująca. Słyszeliście pewne zakłócenia, kiedy rozmawialiśmy tutaj z Campbellem. No i niech was to zastanowi. Pomyślcie na tym, czemu tak może być. No i być może dowiecie się czegoś więcej w kolejnym odcinku, ale gwarantuję wam, że tutaj jeszcze sporo będzie zakręconych tych elementów. Może jeszcze zanim się z wami ostatecznie pożegnam, to zadzwonię do Rose i zapiszę grę, o ile będę mógł.
Hey Jack.
Dobra, jak najbardziej. Zobaczymy, czy ona ewentualnie jeszcze coś nam powie. No i tak jak mówiłem, tutaj mam nadzieję, że zrozumiecie fakt, że było w tym odcinku mało rozgrywki. No ale tak to już akurat w tym przypadku było, że praktycznie prawie pół godziny było rozmów i scenek przerwnikowych, które nam wyjaśniały historię i fabułę.
Jack, I was serious when I said I wanted you to propose to me.
Rose?
I was really worried. There are times when it seems like you're not really looking at me and that if I looked away for a moment, you'll disappear. I wanted to make sure you couldn't get away. I thought that if we lived together, maybe things would change. That maybe we could change things ourselves. But that wasn't the problem. There was something deeper.
I'm sorry.
I guess it's impossible for me.
What are you saying?
I'm sorry, Jack. I love you. I really do. Please believe me. Whatever happens.
Rose?
Bye, Jack.
A więc Rose chciała, żeby Jack się jej oświadczył, bo trochę bała się, że gdy tego nie zrobi, to ona go straci. No cóż, na razie będziemy kończyć, żeby już nie przedłużać, więc jeszcze raz wam dziękuję za oglądanie. Jeśli wam się podobało, to nie zapomnijcie o zostawieniu kciuka w górze. No i prawdopodobnie jutro otrzymacie kolejny odcinek. Cześć!